So, this is the second part of the video I made here at Espresso Royale Cafe after leaving Sweetwater's Cafe downtown Ann Arbor, Michigan. And so I just wanted to demonstrate the proof of how my internet here, with my internet connection here at Espresso Royale Cafe has been consistently censored and hacked, and now remotely suspended, distinctive from everyone else here who uses it in the cafe. So let's go to settings. It's like you think after radiating the hell out of me over years and years, you know, with the aid of University of Michigan student research, you know, illegal, unconsented to, unethical human radiation research, you know, with various forms of spectroscopy, you know, right across the street from the University of Michigan Ann Arbor. You think they'd pay me a little more respect and, leave me alone, you know. I'm not here bothering nobody. I'm just uploading proofs of my personal experience that they should have no idea what it is or what the content is, and have no contribution or retribution against me whatsoever. So let's see. At least they do let me use the goddamn internet, you know. Leave me the fuck alone. Sorry I had to curse, but it's just very frustrating, you know. Jews, you know, just Ann Arbor Jews. It's just enough is never enough for them. Never. Okay, so let's see. Okay. All right. It looks like that's probably the entire video that I made of Sweetwater's Cafe incident earlier today. Let's see, because they're so good at hacking here, they can edit videos. I don't know why this looks
wrong. Lizzie, right? Yeah, I just looked up Michigan law, and I didn't see where it says that there's one is loitering in the business.
Greening.
They
like
don't make
that.
A purchase. Are you sure you know that law correctly?
I just know it's our standard policy that we're not allowed to have people in the cafe who don't purchase anything.
I see.
That's the law, or is our policy in the cafe?
Oh, I'm sorry. You said it was Michigan law earlier today, but it might be. Okay.
Oh, I see.
And then also, you know that you don't have that standard policy.
That's radiation
up there,
in
right?
the background.
Okay,
that's why the camera keeps flicking like that.
Okay, very good, Lindsay. Thank you. Oh, your owners. That's Mr. and Mrs. B, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Now they've just cut the connection here again. If you can see that at the bottom, it says no connection. It's back online. Okay, cool. Mm.
So according to this,
okay. That looks like most of the video. So, I mean, that looks like all of the video, actually. So, all of the second part. So, It's like, this is how I have to strong arm my use of internet here in Ann Arbor, Michigan, at the various small shops. I gotta play these video recording espionage games. But as you can see, there's not many people here at all. Oh, there's some more radiation. I see. People are finally, I think Ann Arbor's getting tired of this, and there you go. They're getting tired of this, and oh, something in that corner. Pipes. Pipes are a big problem in Ann Arbor, Michigan. Somehow they're used with all this electromagnetic energy fields and various forms of radiation to be used as weapons against human beings, to burn them, or to injure their internal organs, and contaminate their blood, to hacking their internet connection. It's a city that's a little too smart for his own good. Seems to draw origin of very humble Caucasians and Jews that, once acquired a little higher knowledge of these high sciences, with the financial backing of a university that is relatively lucrative because